children. Today we are going to learn the concept of clock and time. Children, do you all know what's the time now? Okay, in what do we see the time? Yes, we see the time in the clock. A clock is a device is used for indicating or measuring time. We depend on this clock. The clock helps us to manage our lives. We depend on clock for our daily routine, right from waking up till we go to sleep. Clock teaches how to tell time, but also the right time to do something. Children, in our house, we have a clock. The clock is a very important device in our daily life. Children, can we imagine our lives without clock? No, we cannot imagine our lives without clock, as they keep us regular and punctual in our work. Children, now let's see how to read time in a clock. This is a clock. This is the face of the clock, having numbers from 1 to 12 on it. The clock has two hands. One is shorter hand, another one is longer hand. Shorter hand, also known as our hand. Our hand points to the hour. Our hand completes 2 rounds in a day, which indicates 24 hours of a day. Longer hand, also known as minute hand. Minute hand points to the minute of that hour. Children, now let's learn how to read the time. This is our hand. Our hand is used to read the hour. Our hand points to the number of that current hour. This is minute hand. Minute hand is used to read the minutes. The minute hand moves in clockwise direction. It starts moving from 12 and comes back to 12, completing 60 minutes, which means 1 hour in one round. Whenever the minute hand points straight to number 12, we read the time as o'clock. For example, if the minute hand points to 12 and the hour hand points to 1, we read the time as 1 o'clock. Another example, the minute hand points to 12 and the hour hand points to 2, we read the time as 2 o'clock. Now coming back to the minute hand, let's learn how to read the minutes. The space between two adjacent numbers has 5 divisions. Each division represents 1 minute. The first minute of every hour starts from number 12 is called 0 minute. Now let's count each division between any two adjacent numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So when the minute hand reaches number 1, 5 minutes are completed. Now we will continue counting the next 5 divisions. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So when the minute hand reaches number 2, 10 minutes are completed. In the same way, as we count each number, we do the skip counts of 5. When it reaches to 3, it is 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 25 minutes, 30 minutes, 35 minutes, 40 minutes, 45 minutes, 50 minutes, 55 minutes, 60 minutes. That means it is completed 1 hour. Children, Now let's read the time using both hour hand and minute hand. Now it is showing minute hand points to 12 and hour hand points towards 3. The time is 3 o'clock. Children, now can you read the time? Hour hand pointing towards 6. Minute hand pointing towards 3. Means 6:15. Children, another example. Can you read the time now? Hour hand is in 8 and the minute hand is in 6. Now, what's the time now? 8:30. Children, I hope you all will be able to read the time now onwards. And I hope you all enjoyed today's session. Thank you.